Wait, isn't this guy gonna snap his shit up? Any second now. Any second. What do you mean he's fine? And by the beard of Zeus, where is his belt for God's sakes? What's up, guys? In this video, we're going to talk about a few different things. We're going to talk about deadlifting, round back deadlifting, how to protect yourself when deadlifting with a round back, should you deadlift with a round back, who should deadlift with a round back, as well as give you three different exercises to help strengthen and protect your lower back. The shiny golden deadlift god you see here before you is Konstantin Konstantinovs. The man so nice, they named him twice. Now, he was famous for not only being brutally strong, he pulled 939 pounds beltless, which is just absurd lift. Here he is crushing 430, and he really was just a fantastic lifter. And he was also renowned for pulling with a fairly rounded spine, as you can see here. His upper back is completely hunched over. He gets sort of hunched down over the bar. His spine is in quite a rounded position as he is pulling. However, he never had any issues. He never had any lower back issues to my knowledge, and he pulled this way for years and years and years. He said that if he tried to pull with a flat, neutral spine, he could only pull like 700 pounds or maybe 750. And so him rounding his back put legit 200 pounds on his deadlift. And honestly, the vast majority of competitive powerlifters, when taking maximum attempts, they round their upper back. This is not only to shorten the range of motion, but to increase your leverages off of the start. Here is Dmitry Klokov. He was hitting up a set of five. This is the last two reps. I think this is 225 kilos or almost 500 pounds. And as you can see, he's not in a great position. He's quite rounded over. He doesn't look like he has perfect form, and yet he laughs in Russian. He's fine. Here's another one. This is 250. And it doesn't look like perfect form. If you look at it from the side, he is slightly rounded over. And a lot of top deadlifters deadlift this way, which is why it's weird when I deadlift in a similar way, rounding my upper back. Here is 160 for a set of six. Obviously, a little bit less weight than these guys. But still, when I deadlift in this way, I get tons of criticism. And I think this is completely ridiculous, because people don't criticize the ones who are lifting huge weights and are actually more at risk. They criticize my lifting, even though I'm lifting less weight with similar positions, which I think is completely ridiculous. One important concept is the difference between your upper back and your lower back. Your upper back, your thoracic spine, this is generally okay to round. You can get pretty rounded in this area and have absolutely no issues. Long term, short term, no problems at all. Your lower back, however, if you round your lower back, this can absolutely cause issues under heavy loading. With light lowing, like if you reach down and you tie your shoes, you're just, you know, loading your body weight, this will probably not cause any issues. But if you put, you know, hundreds of kilos in a weird position and you round your lower back, yes, this can cause disc herniations and other issues. So generally speaking, you don't want to round your lower back under very heavy maximal loads. Now, if you look at what is actually happening, what I'm doing is allowing my scapula to hang down. My lats are flexed. You can actually see them in this technique here. And my lower back is actually in a safe position. For some people, if they round their upper back, their lower back rounds with it. Other people, they've trained themselves to round only their upper back. And their lower back actually stays in a safer position because their upper back is rounded. This is a very specific technique, and it does take a while to learn for some people. You have to differentiate between rounding the upper back and the lower back. And this is absolutely critical if you want to round your back. It's absolutely essential to feel your body. Not like that. I mean, feel your positioning. So feel how you are actually moving, where the range of motion is coming from. Rounding your upper back and lower back, they're very, very difficult to feel if you don't really know what is going on. So over time, maybe film yourself, maybe just do some practice in rounding your upper back versus your lower back without loading, and slowly transition to an upper back rounding style. If you want to. If you don't want to, if you're not really competitive, if you don't really care how much you lift, it's not really a big deal. So next, I'm going to give you three exercises that help strengthen the spinal erectors, which are those muscles that go up the spine, and guess what they do? they erect the spine, or they keep it erect under load. And these muscles are absolutely essential for deadlifting as well as correct spinal health. So if you want a healthy back, it's important to have healthy spinal erectors. Now, a lot of people would look at what this Chinese woman is doing in this video and they will instantly say, oh my God, she's gonna hurt her back. She's not gonna hurt her back, okay? She is a trained athlete, she knows her positions, and if you look at where most of the range of motion is coming from, it is the upper and mid back. And the low back is kept in a fairly tight, neutral, stable position. You can see she is bracing. She's taking a deep breath. She's really bracing into that core. I'll do a full video on bracing. I think it's super important. But you can see this is very controlled. She is not just like going up and down very, very rapidly. She is really controlling every inch of the range of motion. And you can see it's mostly upper back. You start rounding with the upper back and you continue down every vertebrae. So you start with the cervical, the neck, and then you go into the thoracic, and then finally you go down vertebrae by vertebrae, rounding, 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 rounding. I wouldn't go super heavy on this. Don't go like over half of your max deadlift or anything like that. It's more of a sort of stretching technique. In fact, it's very popular amongst gymnasts of all people. Now, a lot of people would say, wow, she's gonna hurt herself by doing this movement. And the thing is, she's probably been doing this a while, and the loading is fairly light. This looks like about 30 kilos, which, I mean, for her, for a trained athlete, I don't know how much she lifts, but it's probably more than me. Oh, sad. Big sad. But she's probably strong enough and flexible enough and durable enough to handle this kind of positioning and stress. So here's one of my favorite coaches in the world, Christian Thibodeau. I think that's how you pronounce his name. Demonstrating how to do it. As you can see, you sort of tuck the chin and fold your spine down vertebrae by vertebrae. How would you start doing this? Honestly, I wouldn't even use the bar at first. Just get used to that positioning. Start with just your body weight and then maybe some very light dumbbells. It's often performed on a box, so you actually can get more range of motion. With a barbell, with plates, without a box, you can't get enough range of motion because your spine is going to be so rounded. Doesn't that sound bad? Your spine is rounded. In this context, it's actually a good thing. So in this context, the spine rounding provides a ton of range of motion, which is why a lot of people use a box. This is also used with kettlebells. As you can see, the spine is in a very rounded position. Guess what? Humans are durable. If you train a position, you can get very strong in that position. And so don't be afraid of very light weights and build up over time. Now, I've always been an erector dominant puller. This was 3 years ago, maybe 4 years ago, pulling 180, I think. And as you can see, I'm pretty rounded over. I'm pulling with a lot of spinal erector. Same thing for basically any deficit deadlift. I'm pulling with a lot of spinal erector. And yet, I've deadlifted 4 million kilos in these various degrees of rounding, no pun intended, and I've never had any kind of back pain, any kind of issues, any kind of surgeries, nothing, nothing at all. And this just shows that the human body is very adaptable, and if you put yourself in these positions, you can get very strong and very durable in these positions, provided you listen to your body and you know yourself. You know what positions you can get into without getting injured. So, unsurprisingly, these Jefferson curls felt really, really good. They feel very comfortable, very natural. This bottom position, I'm sure some of you are wincing, but it actually feels really good, just hanging out down there and allowing the weight to rest on my lats, rest on my spinal erectors. And even if I'm very rounded over, I'm rounding in the right way and I'm rounding in the right positions under the correct load. If you progress in the right way, it's a lot safer than if you just load up a bunch of weight. This is not an exercise to max out on. I could go much heavier than this. Honestly, I could probably pull 120, 140, maybe even 160 with this exact same positioning. And that might be too much. But with this, you know, 80 kilos, 100 kilos, there are not going to be any issues just because I've used far more in far worse positions. Now, am I telling you to do this exercise? No, I'm not telling you to do anything. I'm just some guy on the internet, and you should take what I say and internalize it, conceptualize it yourself, and decide what to do for yourself. I assume you're an adult, and if you're not, definitely don't listen to what I'm saying, okay? This is just an idea. Start with light weights if you want to and slowly build up over time. Because if you max out or if you use too much weight, if you're too aggressive or if you're just straight up stupid, this will injure you, okay? I'm just straight up telling you right now, this is an injury possibility. However, it can also really help. So decide for yourself and build up over time if you decide to use this type of exercise. All right, the second exercise is going to be a flexion row. So similar idea, you're in this bent over position and you are rowing a barbell up. So again, you have to brace, you have to stabilize, and this does put a lot of stress on the lower back. Now, I'm sure a lot of you are wincing at this idea, just the very words of stress on the lower back. Stress can hurt, or stress can heal. It just depends on the volume, on the loading, on your genetics, on a lot of different factors. Movement can hurt or movement can heal. As with a lot of stuff, the devil is in the details. For some people, they will get hurt doing this. Know yourself. I'm not putting this out there so people get hurt. If I do a round back deadlift, I qualify it. Unlike some people, if I have quote unquote not perfect technique, or if my technique is different than what some other people should do, I qualify it. I say, this is how I lift. This is the positions that I can get into based on my genetics, based on my training history, based on a lot of different factors. So I would start this exercise with probably just the bar, or maybe even just some very, very light dumbbells. So maybe like 4 kilos, 6 kilos, start with very light weights and just feel that positioning. Also keep in mind, this is a lot more challenging than a normal row. So I normally row with like 80, 100, even 120 kilos, and I'll cheat row like 140 or 150 or 160. For this, I'm using 50 kilos. And trust me, it is very, very challenging to keep posture, to keep that added range of motion, to pull all the way up to the belly is very, very challenging on the traps, on the lats, and on the spinal erectors as well. This is a difficult movement, and you should expect to reduce the weight. I would say cut your normal rowing weight probably in half. All right, now the last movement is going to be the most controversial. It's going to be the most advanced. It is the round-backed good morning. So this is going to be a little bit riskier than the other two movements. With the other two, you can always drop the barbell. With this one, you don't have that luxury. However, it is absolutely a fantastic spinal erector developer. My spinal erectors have never been more sore than with this movement. It'll work them from your ass to your neck. Your entire length of your spine will be sore, or at least the muscles, not the actual joints. But again, I'm not saying to actually do this. This is actually how Bruce Lee hurt his back and it bothered him for the rest of his life. So I don't recommend this exercise. I'm just putting it in there for completeness. If you have any kind of history of lower back pain, don't do this exercise. If you're over like 40 or 50, probably don't do it either. I'm just including it to show a very, very good exercise for the spinal erectors, but start with the other movements first. This is pretty lightweight. It's just 135. Honestly, I've done 90 kilos. I've done 100 kilos, but it's better to stick with fairly lightweight and go for high reps. So typically I'll do 10, 20, 30 or more reps just because that is going to be safer. And honestly, this is not a powerlifting move. There's no real need or benefit in maxing out. And again, I'm sure there's going to be a lot of trolls who say that I'm going to get injured by doing this. And jokes on you, I've been doing this for years and had no issues. So everyone is different. Again, I'm not saying to actually go and do this, but it's just something to open your eyes and realize everyone is different. And if you train to get in weird positions, you can get strong in weird positions. But again, consult your doctor before lifting, blah, 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 disclaimer, disclaimer, disclaimer. And if you do these exercises, which I don't recommend, but do them if you want, start very, very light. So start with less than the bar. Start with just your body weight, really. Just get in these positions. And a lot of people actually find that this helps their back, and their back actually feels stronger and bulletproof by doing this kind of round-backed work. So think outside the box. Don't just think about the standard thoughts of rounding your back is always bad. Open your mind. That's all for this video, and I'll see you next time. Peace.